हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम ऑन माय यूट्यूब चैनल फिजिक्स बाय प्रदीप कुमार। टुडे इन दिस वीडियो वी विल डिस्कस योर नेक्स्ट टॉपिक विच इज़ नथिंग बट कंजर्वेशन ऑफ लीनियर मोमेंटम, विच इज़ इंटरेस्टिंग लॉ विच हेल्प अस to solve some difficult problems in which the Newton's second law cannot apply. Okay, so and very difficult to apply. Okay, so here see conservation of linear momentum. Conservation law of linear momentum. Okay, so first of all we define the conservation law of linear momentum. Okay, so according to this law, if the net force, if the net force acting on the system is zero, then the linear momentum of that system remains constant. Okay, that is linear momentum initial will be linear momentum final. मतलब जो आपका initial linear momentum होगा वही आपका final linear momentum होगा. Okay, so proof देख लीजिए इसका. law F equals to MA and A equals to change in velocity with respect to time implies that F equals to M into delta V by delta T, and this is nothing but M by, write down here, V final minus V initial velocity divided by delta T. Multiply by M, Vf minus M Vi divided by delta T. But this is nothing but the final linear momentum, final momentum of the system minus initial momentum of the system. If F is equal to zero, then P F minus P I divided by delta t equals to 0 implies that Pf minus Pi equals to 0. Therefore, Pf will be equals to Pi. Okay? Which is conservation law of momentum. Okay, this principle we will use in case of collisions. In case of collisions means टक्कर. जहाँ पर two objects से क्या होती है, टक्कर होती है, वहाँ पर हम इस principle को क्या करते हैं, use करते हैं. Suppose करिए कि आपके पास क्या है कि एक object ये है और दोनों objects को आपने move motion देकर, force लगाकर motion देकर छोड़ दिया. तो without any force से move करेंगे और move करने पर इनमें head-on collision होगा. तो collision होगा तो net force acting on this object is zero, net force acting on this object is zero. When both objects are collide, will collide, then during collision there will be a force, but before collision and after collision there is a net force will be zero. So the near, so the momentum before collision and the momentum after collision will remains same in the case of collisions. Okay, remember, in case of collisions force acting on system before and after collision is zero. So in that case, momentum will conserve. Okay, that is momentum before collision equal to momentum after collision. Momentum before collision equals to momentum after collisions. Okay, so suppose we have an example like this. Suppose there is a two balls, both are moving in these directions. Suppose this velocity is u1 and here velocity is u2, mass is m1 and there is mass m2, and after collision this object goes from velocity v1 along this side, and this object goes in this side from v1 m1, and this is goes in this direction v2 of mass m2. Then applying this this direction we will take positive and this direction we will take negative. So net momentum of before collision will be m1 u1 plus m2 u2 equals to net momentum after collision will be m1 v1, but is in a positive direction, that means negative sign, plus m2 v2. By the help of this formula and this principle, we can find out the velocities or masses of the objects before collision or after collision. Okay, but in that cases we cannot apply the Newton's second law because it's very difficult, because the nature of the forces there will be not understood. Okay, so I think aapka topic clear hoga, aur isi topic ke sath sath aapka jo सेकेंड यूनिट का जो पार्ट है आपका चैप्टर नंबर 2 फोर्सेस लॉ ऑफ मोशंस वो आपका कंप्लीट हो जाता है। तो अभी तक हमने 2 चैप्टर्स को कंप्लीट किया, आपका मोशन और दूसरा आपका था लॉ ऑफ मोशंस। अब इसके बाद हम जो चैप्टर आपका स्टार्ट करेंगे वो आपका ग्रेविटेशन होगा, ठीक है ना। तो चलिए यहाँ तक आप इसे कर लीजिएगा। ओके, थैंक यू फॉर वॉचिंग दिस वीडियो।